But one thing that came up, and I think it's going to come up a lot because it came up a lot on Game of Thrones. And I'm sorry for those who haven't seen Game of Thrones, I'm going to spoil a little bit here. But there is a snap heel turn in the last season of Game of Thrones by a main character. And it plays a pivotal role in how the show ends. So now, major spoilers for Dune 2. This is a really sad movie when it comes down to it. The hero becomes a bad person at the end. I saw a funny tweet that said, "Where can I get my hands on the juice that makes you worse?"
You get it from the
Yeah,
worms.
worms. But Chalamet ends the movie with a what is essentially a snap heel turn. Like from the time he drinks the juice that makes you worse to his big, I think, Oscar-worthy
Incredible.
speech, he is like maybe 10 minutes. It's very fast, especially in this. This is a huge, I don't know how long is this?
But I think it was about 2 hours and four, 2.5 hours, 2 hours, 40 minutes, maybe.
Yes, it's a big, big movie.
Yeah, it's crazy. I don't know though, because I don't remember even looking. So like, I didn't care. Because some movies, like I kind of have an idea of how long they are, so I can like in my head, I'm kind of like, okay, we're getting to like this part of the movie, like we're getting to the home stretch now or whatever. Like I knew Driveway Dolls was like 84 minutes. I'm like, okay, we're getting towards like, but like Dune, I almost didn't want to know how long it was, because like I just want it just to show it to me and it'll end when it's over, sort of thing. So yeah, but it had to be like 2.5 hours.
I wish I had known how long Driveway Dolls was because when it ended, I was like, wait, what do you, there's no more? There needs to be more.
That's it.
It's not a lot of time spent on his transformation. I had a couple of friends who bumped up against that and felt that was jarring. And I think that's absolutely deliberate. And this is what I said. Okay, so he did this snap heel turn, which is jarring on purpose because it needs to make you feel uncomfortable. If we, every step of the way, understand why he's leaning more towards going south, leaning more towards taking over, leaning more towards going back on the things he said, then we're going to start sympathizing with why he's doing those things. If it happens all at once, and I'm going to keep saying major spoilers, but like every time I say it, skip ahead of, or maybe just leave and come back later.
After you've seen it, yeah.
Don't listen to me if you haven't seen it. The scene where he tells Florence Pugh that he's going to marry her. You need to have no idea that's coming, even though they do sort of hint at it much earlier in the movie. It needs to feel like it's out of nowhere because you need to feel what Zendaya is feeling. You need to feel that change in her face where you see her stomach fall into her butt and she's gutted because she has now been publicly humiliated. That can't happen if we get like whisper, whisper, he's gonna propose to the Empress. Now, they never ever say before that that he's gonna propose to the Empress. His mother does say, you need to stay single so that our options are open. And this is what she's talking about because she's had the worm juice, she's seen the future. And I think it's handled perfectly. I love a snap heel turn. And I think part of that is because I'm a pro wrestling fan and snap heel turns are really fun.
Well, and Dave Bautista is, the king of the heel turn.
I mean, the day he turned on Rey Mysterio is like one of the greatest snap heel turns of all time.
I literally just explained it to my wife the other day. I was like, here's what makes Dave Bautista great. All right. I wanted to, and I told her all about
About the
it.
Rey Mysterio?
Yeah. Well, that's true. I'm going to rip your head off. I still remember, I can't remember stuff that happened that I watched, on the pay-per-view like a couple of weeks ago, but I remember that Dave Bautista turn.
Yeah, and he has also Dave Bautista, he is the king of the turn because he also has one of the greatest babyface turns of all time. Now, here's the difference. A babyface turn that is gradual is wonderful because this guy you've been booing, but you like, and you keep getting hints. Maybe he'll be good. Maybe he'll be good. Maybe he'll be good. There's always a chance that at the last second, he turns heel all over again. But when
Rips your
Dave
heart out, yeah.
rips your heart out. But when Dave Bautista, well, he was just Bautista at the time, when he finally decided to turn on Triple H and beat up all of Evolution and then won the World Heavyweight Championship. I think that might have been like the one of the first great moments of our friendship was like going through that whole storyline in WWE at the time.